guys, how's it going? I'm Gabby from Go Natural English, and this is Shayna from EspressoEnglish.net. You know, the holidays are coming up. In particular, Thanksgiving is coming up next week, and we wanted to talk a little bit about it. So hey, Shayna, how's it going?
Hey, Gabby, I'm looking forward to the holidays.
Yeah, me too. So what do you usually do for Thanksgiving?
I'm usually together with my family.
Okay.
My family's really close, and so that's my parents, my brother, my grandparents, and various aunts and uncles and cousins.
Nice.
And we all just get along really well. There's no conflicts. Like, we love to laugh together, like just hang out, eat a lot.
Yeah. What kinds of foods do you guys usually make?
Well, my grandmother's an excellent cook, so is my mom. And so there's always turkey, there's soup, there's salad, there's ham, various like snack type things.
Okay.
So I just eat it. I don't have to cook
it. So that's good. I'm trying to remember what my mom used to make when we had like a big family celebration. It's been a while since we've had like a big family celebration, but when I was younger, we would all get together. Definitely turkey.
Mm-hmm.
That's like the thing you have to have. Unless you're vegetarian, then you could do like a tofu turkey. That's
Maybe.
A thing.
Yeah, it is.
Cranberry sauce?
Yes.
Mashed potatoes, sweet potatoes, so a lot of potato starches.
Mm-hmm.
Green beans. Corn, maybe. I'm trying to think what else is traditional Thanksgiving food. Definitely for desserts, pumpkin pie.
Yes.
Love pumpkin pie. Just a lot of food. When I think of Thanksgiving, I think of my stomach being very full and like to the point of feeling like I'm going to burst.
What are they called? They call it like a food coma. Like you
yeah.
feel really sleepy, like, you know, after you eat a really big meal.
Oh, and you know, I'm not like such a big sports person, but isn't there always like the football or something around Thanksgiving?
Yeah, American football.
American football.
I think so. That's when like the season kicks off or something.
Yeah. I just remember, you know, people eating Thanksgiving and then maybe it wasn't even the same day, but like watching football around that time as well. So that's a big thing. American football, of course.
Yes, it's an American tradition.
Yeah.
But besides Thanksgiving, what other holidays do you like?
You know, I'll take any holiday. I love holidays, but I really love New Year's because I've started making it kind of a period not only for celebration, but also to slow down at the end of the year.
Yes.
And reflect or look back on the year that has passed so quickly.
Mm-hmm.
And make plans for the new year. So I really like that. I like that for about a week, in the US at least, it just feels like everyone slows down and relaxes.
Yes.
And you can breathe and you can just spend time with family and friends or maybe travel. A lot of people will travel for New Year's. Actually, last year I was in Mexico and the
awesome.
Year before Brazil, and before that I was probably in Japan, I want to say. So I've traveled a lot for New Year's, but I just like the feeling that I get where I can stop, kind of reflect and plan for a new beginning, so to speak. What about you? What do you look forward to for holidays?
I really like that period as well, for exactly the reasons you said.
Nice.
Just a chance to slow down, because I think we're always rushing around in the US, and especially as entrepreneurs, you know, we have a lot of stuff to do. And
always.
I love reflecting as well. I write like a summary of my year, like how it went.
Oh.
And New Year's itself, we always spend with my best friend's family in their beach house, but don't get too excited because the beach house is in New Jersey, so there is snow on the beach. So
no swimming, no.
No.
Okay.
You know, I've seen a guy in a wetsuit braving the waves for like surfing,
but
it's cold. Yeah, it's really
it.
Cold. And so, but we have fun just enjoying each other's company, you know, enjoying hopefully the end of a year that we lived well and we accomplished some things. And also looking forward to that new beginning.
Yeah,
so.
I love that. I'm really looking forward to it now. It's coming soon.
Are you spending New Year's in Brazil this year?
I think so. I think I'm going to go to Brazil because, well, for a few reasons. It's a lot warmer than New
York. I'm jealous.
I mean, New York City is an amazing place to be for New Year's. You probably know, you know, the ball drops in Times Square, and there's that. But I really love the beach and I love warm weather, and I think it will be fun. And it'll be nice to get away for a little bit and be in a different environment where I can just pause and reflect and maybe do some journaling, mm-hmm. reflecting on my year. When I'm in New York, I feel like there's always things I want to go out and do, and
yes.
and yeah, so it'll be nice. That's the plan anyway. We'll see. What about you? Where are you thinking of spending New Year's?
You know, I'm honestly not even sure this year.
Yeah.
Plans are all up in the air, but
maybe your friends in the beach house.
Yeah, yeah, actually they're traveling right now, so they're out of the country, so no luck there. But we'll figure out something.
Yeah,
fun
there's
to
still
do.
Time.
We always do.
Nice.
But I feel like in the U.S. we don't have that many holidays, though, maybe as some other countries.
Yeah, I know. Well, I think that there's very few big ones where they're federal, you know, nationwide holidays where you know the bank's going to close and, you know, some people have the day off, we'll say. And what would that be, like New Year? Well, Christmas, New Year's. Thanksgiving? Probably Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving's a holiday, yeah.
Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's.
Fourth of July.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, we skip like all those, you know, January, February, March, April, May. There might be like one, isn't like President's Day or Martin Luther King Day, some people celebrate. There's a lot of gray area. I think it depends on your job and even the city you live in, what's going to be a big holiday or not.
Yeah. Actually, when I was living in Brazil, it was sometimes frustrating because I was living in Bahia, the state of Bahia in Brazil, and there were actually too many holidays. So, for example, Carnival would be like at least a week, maybe 10 days, and then there would be all sorts of days for like the Catholic saints, religious holidays, and so things would close, and I would actually be frustrated. I mean, I love celebration. I love like all the different kinds of celebration that you have, but sometimes it would be frustrating because I felt like you said, the bank is closed. How do you get things done? I don't know.
It's interesting because here we don't really have saints days. I guess Christmas is a time of day or about a week, depending on where you work, but you get that time off, but we don't really have the saints days like you have in Brazil. So that's interesting. But yeah, there's a lot of good holidays coming up. That's why we call this period of time the holidays.
Yes.
Because we can look forward to definitely having some holidays coming up. So yeah.
I would love to hear from actually people who are watching what holidays you have in your country, because there are some
question.
That we don't even know about and we'd love to learn. So if you have a holiday in your country that is unique or you just really enjoy, then leave a comment, right?
Yeah. And if I can ask another question, I'm curious if you celebrate any American holidays. Do you celebrate Thanksgiving? Do you celebrate Halloween in your country? I would be interested to know both of these things. So
yeah, not the 4th of July, right? Because that's American Independence.
Yeah. But if you celebrate that, that's kind of interesting, but you probably don't, but it's
right.
Okay. Well, great. So this is our third conversation of four. Mm-hmm. So next week, you can join us again on Friday for another conversation. We're going to be talking about a really special project that, you know, we've worked on together three times now. Going into
this will be the one year anniversary. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So we're going to be talking about how the English Power Pack came about, why we do it, and just having a conversation about what we're excited about in that. So
I'm excited.
Yeah. Me too.
Awesome.
Awesome. So if you want to learn more about Shayna, she's at espressoenglish.net, and I'm Gabby at gonaturalenglish.com. We'll see you next week.
See
Bye.
You.